We've learned a bunch of concepts now, and I'm thinking it might be a good idea to kind of tie them together in one program. And so, as I thought about exciting programs, I realized we're pretty limited in the excitement level of the programs we can do at this point, but there are some things we can do. So, I thought maybe we could do like a coin flip program where we could ask the user to say heads or tails, and then we would flip a coin and then make a decision on whether they got the heads or tails part right. And then, I don't know, maybe keep track of how many times they got it right. Maybe that's something we can do in this program. And so let's, again, I kind of like to start by mapping it out, not just start writing the program. That's the tendency, is to just get in and start writing it. But it's helpful if we go through and say, what is it that we're going to do in this program? And just write it down in our own English-like language to figure out the logic part before we ever start trying to program it. It's easier to fight the two battles separately, right? Divide and conquer. So we're going to start out. We know that we want to ask the user whether they want to select head or tail. So let's start there. So we're going to ask the user to select heads or tails on the coin. Okay. And then we're going to get the input from them on whether they select heads or tails. The problem is you can only select heads or tails. And so we have to make a decision, right? What if they type something that wasn't heads or tails? So I'm going to say if the input is not valid, then we're going to print invalid input. So maybe I'll put this in quotes and then try again, maybe. Okay. I guess that needs to be in quotes as well. So invalid input, try again. And then we're going to need to get the input again, right? Well, what if it's still invalid? Well, this is where it might not be a bad idea to use, instead of an if statement, we can use a while loop, right? And say, while the input's not valid, keep getting the new input, and keep doing that forever until they enter a good input. Or end the program, I guess. So after we've gotten valid input, what do we want to do? Well, we want to say, if the user picked heads, and the coin flip was heads. Now I just realized I haven't actually flipped the coin yet. And so before we can make a decision, we need to simulate the flipping of the coin. Okay? And so once we've simulated the flipping of the coin, then we can make the decision. If the user picked heads, then the coin flipped was heads. Then what do we want to do? Well, we want to print, it was heads, and then print you win. Okay, what if the user picked heads and the coin flip was tails? Then what do we want to do? Well, then we want to print it was tails, print you lose. Okay. Well, then we have the opposite scenarios. We can say if the user picked tails and the coin flip was tails, then we can print it was tails and then you win. And if the user picked tails and the coin flip was heads, then we can print it was tails and you lose. Okay, so we've got our different situations. The only thing we haven't implemented is multiple flips. If we want to do this all multiple times, then what does that mean? Well, it means we need to put it inside of some sort of loop, right? And so what do we, the question with the loops is always, what do we want to do over and over and over again? Do we want to ask the user to select heads or tails over and over again? Well, the answer is yes. Do we want to get their input over and over again? Yes. Do we want to do all of these decisions, simulate the flipping of the coin over and over again? Yes. And so we're going to put all of this inside a loop. The question is, what kind of a loop do we want to use? If we know specifically how many games we're going to let the user play, like if we're going to let them flip 10 coins, then that would be a definite loop situation, and we could use like a for loop for that. Okay. If we don't know, if we're just going to let them keep flipping and see how many times they want to flip it, which is kind of what I had in mind, then we can, so we're just going to let them flip it and keep flipping it and then just keep track of how many times they guessed correctly. And so in that situation, it's an indefinite loop. We don't know how many times it's going to be done, right? So then the question is, do we want it to be a while loop or a do while loop? The question, do we want to have them play at least once? And the answer, I think, is probably yes. And what that tells me then is we want to use a do while loop. So we're going to do all of this stuff. Okay, and I don't think I can, let me try indenting a line at a time. Yeah, it doesn't work in Notepad. Should have picked a better tool. Okay, so let's, I got to keep my indentation correct from a readability perspective. So all of this stuff now needs to shift over because it's inside the do while loop. So I'll move everything over. In JGrasp, you can just highlight everything and then hit the tab key and it'll all move it over, or move it all over, sorry. So we're going to do all of this stuff while some condition is true. And what's the condition? Well, while the user wants to play again. So we could say something like, play again, question mark, Y or N. Well, and we don't want to play again while we ask them a question. So that was probably a bad way of doing that. We want to ask them the question first. So we want to print play again Y or N. See, you start to want to write code as you're doing this. And then we want to keep playing while what? While, when I guess we ought to say get user input, and then we want to keep playing while the user typed Y. Okay, that'll be our condition. All right, anything we want to do, anything else we want to do in this program? Well, I talked about keeping track of the number of times they guessed correctly. And we probably then ought to keep track of how many times we actually played, right? And again, I'm kind of making this up on the fly. I don't know if this is the best way of doing this game, but it'd be kind of interesting to say what percentage of the time did they get the correct coin flip, right? And so what I'm going to do then is if every time we flip the coin, I'm going to increment the number of flips. So I'll have one variable that'll keep track of the flips. And then over here, and when I win, I'll increment the number of wins. Okay, I don't want to increment on a loss, so I got to come down here to the tails flip. And then here I can increment the number of wins as well. So we can keep track. So this part will keep track of the number of flips. Every time we flip a coin, we'll add one to that number, and then we'll also keep track of number of wins in those situations where the user won. Well, that means that after I get outside this loop, I can then print U1 and then the number of wins. Out of this can be the number of flips. Okay. Now again, this isn't Java. This is just me kind of doing a half and half with Java and English. And I can't help myself. I'm a stats kind of guy, so I want to know that's the percentage of the time, something like that. Okay, so you get the idea for the program here. We've gone through and just kind of mapped it out in words what we're going to do in this program. Okay, I'm going to keep track of coin flips. I'm going to follow this code, keep doing it as long as they want to keep flipping the coin. We'll just keep doing it over and over again, and then in the end we can print out the number of wins versus the number of flips and then calculate a percentage for that. Okay, so that's the what we call the pseudocode for the program, just kind of the logic for the program. Now we can take this pseudocode to Java and actually write the program. Does that sound okay? All right. That's coming up next. Spencer out.